Welcome back. This is lesson 3 of class 3, the Holy Spirit. And today, we will be dealing with being guided and led by the Holy Spirit. One of the greatest benefits we have is to be led by the Spirit of God through the Word of God. One of the greatest benefits we have is to be led by God through His Holy Spirit. The leading of the Holy Spirit is conveyed through the written and spoken word of God. According to 1 Corinthians 2:12, the Bible says, "Now we have received not the spirit of the world, but the spirit which is of God, that we might know the things that are freely given to us of God." I.e., that the Holy Spirit reveals to us the things that are ours, that God has given unto us. We are guided by the Holy Spirit, bearing witness with our spirit on things that pertain to life and godliness. Romans chapter 8 from verse 14 says, "For all who are led by the Spirit of God are children of God. For you did not receive a spirit of slavery to fall back into fear, but you have received a spirit of adoption, when we cry, Abba, Father." It is that very spirit bearing witness with our spirit that we are the children of God. I often say this, that one of the assurances I have anytime the enemy comes to me or tries to confuse me about my faith, about my Christianity, is remembering and recalling the times that God has led me through His Word, by His Spirit. And I recollect Romans 8, where it tells me that every time I am led by the Spirit of God, it confirms that I am a son of God, and it shuts up the enemy instantly. Always remember that the Bible teaches that the Spirit of God and the Word of God agree. So the leading of the Holy Spirit is always going to be in tangent with the Word of God. Anytime the Spirit of God speaks to us, to always be in line with what is in God's Word. Anything contrary to the written Word of God is not from the Holy Spirit. It does not contradict the Word of God. Fellowshipping with the Holy Spirit is sharing our deepest thoughts and feelings with Him and being influenced by His leading. We stay full of the Spirit by maintaining a tender heart before Him, speaking the Word into our lives, praising and worshiping God, praying and giving thanks. Ephesians 4 from verse 29 says to us, "Let no evil talk come out of your mouth, but only what is useful for building up as there is need, so that your words may give grace to those who hear. And do not grieve the Holy Spirit of God, with which you are marked with a seal for the day of redemption. Put away from you all bitterness and wrath and anger and wrangling and slander, together with all malice, and be kind to one another, tender-hearted, forgiving one another, as God in Christ has forgiven you." Ephesians 5 from verse 17 says, "So do not be foolish, but understand what the will of God is. Do not get drunk with wine, for that is debauchery, but be filled with the Spirit, as you sing psalms and hymns and spiritual songs among yourselves, singing and making melody to the Lord in your heart, giving thanks to God the Father at all times and for everything in the name of our Lord Jesus Christ." Anytime people tell me, "I don't hear God. I don't know what God is saying to me. I've read scripture, it's not making sense to me." Oftentimes I refer them to these verses I've just shared with you and ask them, "Is there anything in this area that you need to correct? Is there anything that you're doing that you need to correct?" 1 Thessalonians 5:19 says, "Do not quench the Spirit." So anytime we need the Holy Spirit to talk to us, to minister to us, it is based on our relationship with Him. So if you stifle the Spirit, you are not able to hear Him. Another translation says, "Stop stifling and suppressing the Spirit." So it's important for us to be open to the Holy Spirit, to keep our relationship with the Holy Spirit in good condition, in good shape, by constantly praying, studying and meditating on the Word of God, spending time in worship, in praise, and interaction with the Spirit of God. I hope you've taken something away from this lesson. See you in the next class.